Once again, she heard somebody is calling out her name, Agar. Somebody is calling Agar, Agar later. And then again, she thought it may be because of her disappointment, and it may be an imagination of her mind that you have seen. And then also she may thought that it may be due to the mercy of God. The God's mercy is already there. Due to the mercy of God, she may feel that somebody is calling her name, or maybe God's mercy may be calling her name, etc. So many such doubts are there. But after some time, Hagar understood somebody is actually calling out her name, Hagar. And then when you come to the towards the end of the page, you can see as in the dream, then as in the dream, the paragraph is beginning like that. She chanced upon the source of the sound. So now she understood actually the name Hagar is called out by a mysterious word, and that word is a mysterious word. And so she thought that it might be a dream, but actually it was not a dream. Actually there was a bird, but that bird is a mysterious bird. And now that bird is flailing the ground with its wings, or the bird is touching its wings continuously upon the desert, and in order to get some water. And now after so many times, what happened is blood is coming out from the wings or feathers of this bird, because it was continuously flapping its wings upon the ground. So after some time, blood appeared upon its wings, and continuously. So when it is flapping its wings upon the desert, and it is calling out the name Hagar, Hagar, later. And now the bird's feathers are scattered here and there, but it is not stopping its flailing. And at last, it wanted to, the earth should be open. That means there should be a water source should be there. It wanted to drink some water. And after some time, what happened, you can see towards the end of that page, in the last paragraph, you have seen Hagar to transfixed. That means Hagar became very surprised. And why Hagar was surprised, that you have seen a spring is gushing forth from the earth. And there is another next comparison you can underline. And there, all of a sudden, an unexpected spring, a water source was coming, or water started coming out from the desert. So that was actually a real miracle, a great surprise. Usually, a spring will not be there in a desert, but all of a sudden, when the bird was continuously flapping its wings, all of a sudden, a small spring started from this desert. So that gushing forth means all of a sudden something is coming out like a fountain. And so it is compared to a water squirting from the eyes of a pierced coconut. So when you pierce the eyes of a coconut, water will be coming out all of a sudden from the eyes of the coconut. Similarly, all of a sudden the earth was opened and water started coming out like a mountain, like a fountain. And so that is what is the comparison, that also you can note down there. So many comparisons, similes, etc. you can see in this lesson. And then incredulously, that means that was unbelievable for Hagar. In order to find out such a water rushing forth from the desert, that was unbelievable. And so she stood and watched the bird was drinking ravenously. So now for the bird, it was also the last survival for it. So now the bird started drinking from the spring again and again. And now it also dipping in the water. It dipping its body, filling its body completely in the spring. And then it is covering or flapping its wings in a joyful celebration, or the bird is expressing its happiness by flapping its wings continuously and moving through this pool, this water source, etc. And then what happened, you can see in the continuation. In a flash, Hagar also started screaming, because all this time Hagar was so disappointed thinking about a water source. And so now all of a sudden she has seen a water source, and so Hagar can't control her happiness at all, so she started screaming. So what did she do? And look at the next line that you can underline, and that also shows the motherly care of Haga. She flew to the spring and immersed her son in the water. So now she is not drinking water for the first time. First she took the baby from the desert and put the baby into that pool. So that also shows the sacrificing mentality of Haga. She gave the main priority to this son survival. And then she is also Haga, how much she was happy, delighted, that you can see in the screen line. And that you can see now she started drinking water, and also she herself was also immersed in the pool again and again. And now more and more water is coming out from the water source, and then Haga is soaking her full body in the stream. And now you can underline that another miracle came there. So the water is coming like a fountain was a miracle. Second miracle was also coming there. As you have seen in the previous pages, paragraph, you have seen when Haga's body was dehydrated, the milk in her breast was not there. The blood also became very thin. But when her body was immersed in the water, and when she started drinking water, a miracle happened. That is, she felt that milk started produced in her breast. And that was also described as a miracle here. Water turning into milk. When she started drinking water, and when her body became very cool in that pool, and she feel that the milk is flowing through her breast. And now what happened, you can see in the next paragraph. And she and her son Ishmael and now settle down, they settle down nearby this lake, a small pool. And then there's a description is given about that particular portion that you can underline. And this particular lake is between the barren hills and the thorny bushes. Barren means empty. So in between the barren mountain or empty mountain, and also between thorny bushes, this lake is there. And now this mother and son, they settle down in this particular portion. And then Hagar became very thankful to this bird, because only because of this bird and she and her son came back to life. So she understood how much important water in the life of a human. Each drop of water is actually it is a drop of life. She understood the importance of that. And so now when you go through the last portion of that paragraph, she says she felt humbled by the ways of God. So now you have seen already Hagar had an optimism in her mind, and that is Hagar believed that God might have thought about one safe path.